My soul died, but my body is alive.
It was here, isolated in a 6 by 10 foot cell, where Candy Haley wrote that poem.
I would say I've been through hell and back.
She spent nearly 2.5 years of her 3 years in jail in solitary confinement at New York's Rikers Island, awaiting trial for a crime for which she was never convicted.
I would just pray and think of a way to kill myself. Pray to God that I would die and ask him, why am I being punished like this if he knows I'm innocent?
Candy typically spent at least 23 hours alone in her cell, a few feet away from an often dirty toilet. The Associated Press gained exclusive access to a woman's solitary cell. Here at Rikers, solitary is known as the Bing. Candy often earned time by lashing out at guards, disobeying orders.
Inmate Ms. Haley was again given some more direct orders to remove her clothing, but failed to comply with Officer Reed's orders by becoming disorderly and using profanities.
Candy also piled up time for numerous other infractions. When she cut her wrists with shards of glass, she was slapped with 90 days in solitary for possession of contraband. Her refusals to stop trying to kill herself often resulted in more time. When she was denied sanitary pads and used her jumper to stop the bleeding, that earned her time for destruction of jail property.
I found it shocking that a person who was accused of a crime, not convicted of a crime, but accused of a crime, could be kept in such horrific conditions.
Candy developed a destructive cycle of behavior. The more she got in trouble, the more she'd act up.
Solitary confinement makes the people placed in it often become insane, crazy, psychotic.
There are more than 2.2 million people incarcerated in the United States, the highest number in the world. Solitary confinement is the most commonly used method of punishing difficult inmates. On any given day, 80 to 100,000 people are held in solitary confinement in state and federal prisons across the country, and that figure may be low. New York City recently discontinued the practice amongst the young and mentally ill. James Gilligan has overseen mental health programs in jails and prisons.
Solitary confinement is one of the most effective means of rendering people incapable of controlling their impulses, of becoming paranoid and fearful that they're being surrounded by enemies even when they're not.
Prior to her time in jail, Candy had no record of mental health problems. Now she's constantly paranoid officials at Rikers are still after her, setting her up. She's attempted suicide twice.
My name is Candy Haley, and I'm a solitary survivor.
8 months after her release, Candy's day-to-day life is a struggle. She's a staunch advocate for ending solitary confinement and speaks out at Board of Corrections meetings. But afterwards, she'll often leave with no place to go. She lost custody of her two kids, her apartment, her job. At times, she sleeps on trains to stay warm.
I think it all came from solitary confinement. I don't think I'll ever be normal again.
Candy often questions if it would be better in jail than homeless. But then she quickly remembers her time in the Bing. In New York, Bonnie Ghosh, Associated Press.